My name is Micah Jones. I'm an orthopedic surgeon at LewisGale Hospital. I subspecialize in adult hand and upper extremity, as well as I do all the pediatric hand and upper extremity for the hospital and the surrounding areas. Total elbow replacement surgery is a joint replacement surgery for the elbow. It's usually seen in patients with post-traumatic arthritis, osteoarthritis, or rheumatoid arthritis. Typically seen in the 60 plus age population, unless someone has a severe injury to their elbow. And if the elbow is injured so severely it can't be fixed with plates and screws, sometimes the only alternative is to do a total elbow replacement. Total elbow replacement is basically resurfacing of the distal part of the elbow, and you're putting a hinged component in there to give pain relief and also to help with motion. Typically, this is what the implant looks like. You have a component going into the humerus right here, and you have a hinge in this portion of the elbow, and then there's another component here that gets cemented into the ulna, and that's what forms your new elbow replacement, and that's what forms the new elbow joint, and that allows you to move the elbow in a non-painful manner. Both components are cemented into the arm. This little flange is something new that is actually very important. It helps with stability of the implant. Typically, these last between 20 to 25 years. They do have a very specific limitation on weight restrictions. It's 10 pounds and 2 pounds. So it's a 10 pound maximum lifetime weight restriction and 2 pounds repetitive weight restriction. So it's a very particular patient population that we put these in, because that's a very specific limitation of weight restriction that you wouldn't want to put that weight limitation on a laborer, for example, because they won't do well with this. They'll wear their total elbow out. Surgery for a total elbow replacement takes about 3.5 to 4 hours. I usually keep patients overnight for a 23-hour observation. I usually put a drain in the elbow, and that comes out post-op day one. Patients go home on the first day post-operatively. They're in a splint that stays on for approximately 10 to 14 days. Then we take the sutures out and get them moving right away. They do usually require physical therapy afterwards, and I see them regularly every 2 to 4 weeks intervals for about the first 3 months to make sure the implant is stable and they're doing well from a post-operative point of view. The lifetime restriction, once again, is 10 pounds one-time lifting or 2 pounds repetitive lifting. That's the main thing. The other thing to consider with the joint replacement surgery in general, whether it's your hip, your elbow, your shoulder, or your knee, is you do have to have prophylactic dental antibiotics. Anytime you're getting a dental procedure, you need to have antibiotics before the dental procedure, and that helps us as surgeons protect the implant that's inside of your hip, shoulder, knee, or elbow. The last thing we want is for your elbow joint to get infected. The best candidate for a total elbow replacement is someone who either had a severe injury to the elbow where the bones were so shattered that they're not repairable, or someone with rheumatoid arthritis who has chronic pain from a motion standpoint or a day-to-day standpoint, someone who is not a skilled laborer, someone who is no longer doing heavy laborious work, because the limitations of the elbow replacement do not allow for that. So typically it would be a patient 65, 70 years old who has chronic elbow pain, arthritis, maybe rheumatoid, potentially had a previous fracture, and now they have a stiff arthritic elbow and it hurts them on a daily basis. They failed conservative management, including injections or splinting or therapy, and really the pain is affecting their daily life. That's the best candidate to have a total elbow replacement.